Hello students, I hope all of you are well. So let's start the class. In the last few days, we were doing MS Word 2013, the different various features of MS Word. In the last day, I discussed about how to insert a table in MS Word document. I believe you have understood the last video. So in today's class, I want to discuss about how you can add a new row, a new column, and how you can delete rows and columns. For example, I have created one table and I have inserted some values or data as well. But I want to insert one more column. Say after roll number, I want to insert a column. The heading of the column will be admission number. Then how can I insert? Or say I want to insert a particular row because a new student has joined in our school. I want to insert the name of the students. So I want a new row at the end. So how can I add? So I will discuss in the class that how can you add a new row or new column, or how if you want to delete something, if you want to delete any record also, how you can delete a record. That I'm going to explain you today. So for example, say after, if I want to insert a new row, how can I insert? Okay, so first, say after 4, I want to, after you know the last row, I want to insert a new row, 5th row. How can I insert? You can go to the last cell, the last row, and you can right click. Once you right click, you will get a various option. Out of this, you have to select insert option. If you click on insert, you will get lots of option. And you can select insert rows above, insert rows below. In my case, I want to insert the row below. So I have to select insert row below. So let's click on this option if you want to insert above. Then you have to click on insert row above. But in my case, I want to select insert row below. So here it is. A new row has inserted. Okay. Here you can select your desired data. Okay. I'm just writing the name. House and activity like this. So this is how you can insert a row. If I want to insert a column, say after roll number, I want to insert a column, then I have to click on roll number cell. Then again, I have to right click and I need to click on insert. And then if you want to insert a column to left, then you have to select left. If right, then right. Okay. So I want to insert the cell to the right because after roll number. So I will select insert column to the right. Here it is. So here I can write admission number. Like this, and here you can write admission number, say S001, like this. I'm just writing randomly. In this way you can write. Okay, so this is how you can insert a particular row or particular column in a particular position. Okay, but in your book, as I'm using 2016 version, the option that I have instructed, you will get in your version as well. But in your book, there is a different option which is not there in 2016. Like if you want to insert a row or column, then in the layout option, you will get in case of 2013, I'm talking about, if you have 2013 version, then if you want to insert the row and column, then in the same way you can insert. Otherwise, in 2013 version, in the layout tab, you will get an option called row insert row above or insert row below. You will get an option. From there also you can insert row and column above or below. But in 2016 version that I'm using, there is no such options. So I'm using the just right clicking, and from this insert option I am inserting the rows and the column. If you are using 2013 version or any other version also, you can do the same way, right? Right click on the cell, the particular cell, and you will get an insert option. And from there, you can select, you can insert, or you can insert rows, or you can insert row columns in your desired position. Now I'm going to tell you how to delete a row or column. It's very simple. If you say I want to delete the last, last row, if I want to delete, then I will select delete cells. Okay, so if you click on delete cell, you will get option that delete entire row, delete entire column. I don't want to delete entire column, right? I want to delete a entire row, so I will select delete entire row. After that I'll click on okay. If you want to select the If you want to delete any column, then again you have to right click on the cell. Then again you have to click on delete cells, and you have to select delete entire column, because now I want to delete the entire column. Then you have to click on OK. So this is how, students, you can insert and row column, and you can delete row and column as well. So please practice at your home and comment in the comment box. And you have understood or not, please comment. That's all for the class. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.